Hello friends, welcome to Learner's Planet. Friends, in this session we are going to discuss about syllogism. Now what's that? See, sometimes in a particular given question, two statements are given and two conclusions are given. Now we have to assume the statements to be true, whether they are related to truth or maybe they are far from the truth, or they vary from commonly known facts, right? But we have to assume them to be true. Now, after that, two or three conclusions are given based on these statements. Now, we have to judge whether these given conclusions follow the given statements or not. I can say whether this conclusion logically follow the given statements or not. Maybe the given statements are far from the truth or far from the commonly known facts, right? So, good number of questions are being asked on syllogism in various entrance examination. It is a part of logical reasoning as well. So, let's take some question based on syllogism so you'll get better idea what I'm trying to tell you. So, let's begin. And friends, I would suggest you to attend the session of Venn diagrams before you come to this session, because we will be taking the help of Venn diagrams to solve the problems based on syllogism, right? Now, just read the instructions. Two statements are given in the question followed by two conclusions. Consider the two statements to be true even if they seem to be at variance from the commonly known facts, and choose the correct option about conclusions which logically follows from the two given statements, right? Now, options, what are the options? Option A is only conclusion 1 follows. Option B, only conclusion 2 follows. Option C, either of them. Option D, neither of them. And option E, both of them, right? So, the option will remain same. Now, we have to read the statements and read the conclusion and choose which of the option is correct, right? So let's take the first question. Now let's take this first question. Here the statements given are all pencils are bricks and all bricks are bottles. So first of all, we draw the diagram, Venn diagram of it. Now all pencils are bricks. That means the set of pencil is subset of bricks, or we can say set of bricks. So first of all, let's draw the circle for that. Now, this inner circle is all pencils are bricks. That means this circle is pencil and this circle is bricks, right? Now, the next is all bricks are bottles. That means we have one more circle, that is outer circle, because all the bricks, that means this circle is coming under the circle of bottles, right? Or we can say the set of brick is subset of bottles. So I just draw another circle as well. Okay. So this circle is circle of bottles. Now we draw the Venn diagram. Now let's judge the first conclusion. All pencils are bottles. Now pencil is the innermost circle and pencil is subset of brick and brick is subset of bottle. That means pencil is subset of bottle. That means all pencils are bottles, because the circle of pencil is coming inside the circle of bottles. So this conclusion is true. Now all bricks are pencil. Now bricks, the circle of bricks is outer side the circle of pencil. So all bricks cannot be pencil, because we have this shaded area as remaining portion of the bricks which are not pencils, right? So this statement is incorrect. This conclusion is incorrect, right? So which option we have to follow? That is only conclusion 1 follows, right? That is option A. Okay. So it is option A, that is only conclusion 1 follows. I hope you are clear. Now, the next is The statements are all tigers are ships. So first of all, let's draw the circles. So this is the circle of tigers. And all tigers are ships. That means the set of tiger is the subset of ships. Now the next statement is some ships are cupboards. Now the Venn diagram will take a different shape over here. So some ships are cupboards. Let's draw the status. Now friends, when we draw some ships are cupboards, we may get two types of diagrams. Maybe the set of tigers is not coming in this cupboard circle, and maybe it is coming, right? So we have an ambiguity over here, right? Now let's see the conclusions. First of all, some ships are tigers, right? So some ships are tigers. See, all the tigers are ships. That means some portion of ships is coming under tigers. So this conclusion is correct, right? Now the next conclusion is some cupboards are not ships. See friends, we are given that some ships are cupboard. That means this is the common area of ships and cupboards. Here if we see, this is the common area of ships and cupboards, right? So we can say some ships are cupboards. That means some cupboards are ships, but we cannot say some cupboards are not ships, because we are not sure about this negation, right? So we are not sure about conclusion two, or we can say conclusion two is not reasonable. So we are convinced about only conclusion one, that is some ships are tigers. So further, the answer would be only conclusion one follows, that is option A, right? Now this common portion always shows the sum portion common between these two circles. That means some ships are cupboards, or we can say some ships are tigers, right? So this is the common portion that we have to be careful. If some ships are cupboards, that means some cupboards are ships, right? Both the statements are same. I hope you are clear. Now let's take this question. Some stones are cups. So first of all, let's draw the circles. So here, some stones are cups. So this is a circle of stones, and this is a circle of cups. And this is the portion that is common between the two. That is, some stones are cups. So this is the area representing that fact. Now, the next is, some cups are black. Now, what there are further two possibilities. So I would draw the Venn diagram for both the possibilities. Just listen to me carefully. Now, some cups are black. Now, this is a circle of black. Now, this some cup portion can be drawn over here also and over here also. It is stones, cups and black. You got the difference between these two diagrams? In this particular diagram, stones and black, some common portion is there, and over here stone and black, these are disjoint sets, right? So we have the two options for these two statements. Now let's come to the conclusions. Now the first conclusion is, further it is a negative conclusion, so we cannot be so sure that some blacks are not cups. See, we know that some blacks are cups because we have common portion over here also and over here also. This portion is common between cups and black, and here also this portion is common between cups and blacks. So we are sure that some blacks are cups or some cups are black, but we are not sure that some blacks are not cups. So it's not the correct conclusion. Now, some cups are stones. Simply, some stones are cups as it is given. So some cups will also be stones, as this is the common portion, right? Or we can say in both the diagrams, it is satisfying, right? So some cups are stones. That is the conclusion that can be drawn. So this is the correct. Now, only option two is correct. That means thus conclusion 2 is following, that means option B is correct, that only conclusion 2 follows, right? Now, next is all books are pencils. First of all, let's draw the diagram. So all the books are pencils. That means the inner circle is of books. All the books are pencils. So the outer circle is of pencils, right? Now the next is all pencils are pens. That means all the pencils are pens. That means we will have one more outer circle, and the circle of pencil will come inside that. So this is the circle of pens. Okay. Now let's come to the conclusion. This is the innermost circle of books, then pencils, then pens, right? Now some pens are books. Some pens are books. Yeah, it will be true, because this entire circle is of pens and book is having some portion in this entire circle. That means some pens are books. That is correct, right? Now no pen is a book. It cannot be true, because some portion of the pens is occupied by the circle of books. So some pens will be books, definitely. So no pen is a book. That is incorrect, right? So only only conclusion one follows, that means option A, right? Now next is all papers are files. So this is a diagram. This is papers and this is files. So all the papers are inside the circle of files. Now some files are pens. Further, we have two options to draw the second statement. So we have these two options, right? All papers are files. Here I just write, this is paper, this is file, and some files are pens. So some portion of this circle is pens. So this can be like this also, and this can be like this also. Okay, now we have the two diagrams for these two statements. Now let's come to the conclusion. The first is no paper is a pen. So from this we can say no paper is a pen, because in pen and paper nothing is common, right? So this can be true if this diagram is true, right? Now next is some pens are papers. Pens and papers. Right, some pens are paper if this diagram is true. Now just be very careful that either this diagram is true or this diagram is true, right? If this diagram is true, conclusion 2 follows. If this diagram is true, conclusion 1 follows. That means either this or this is true. Both of them simultaneously cannot be true, but either this or this be true, because either this diagram is correct or this diagram is correct, right? So we will take option C, that is either 1 or 2 follows. I hope you are getting me. No paper is a pen. So this is the diagram where paper and pen, there is no common point between the two, and some pens are papers, that is some point, some area which is common between pen and papers. So this is the circle of pen, this is the inside circle, that is our paper, and some portion is common, right? So either this or this is true. It's really a good example of option C, that both the things cannot be true simultaneously. So either this is true or this is true. So option C. I hope you are getting me. Now next is some chairs are steels. So let's draw the diagram. So this is some chairs are steel. That means some area is common between chairs and steels. So this is chairs and this is steel. And this is the common portion. That means some chairs are steel, or we can say some steel is chairs, right? Now next is some steels are wood. Further, we have two types of diagram over here. Just see it here. Some steels are wood. Now this is the circle of wood. Now wood can be like this, or it is it's chair, it is steel, and it is wood. Now, wood can be, the circle of wood can be drawn like this or like this. That means some portion of wood and chair is common, and in this case, no portion of chair and wood is common, right? Chair and wood are disjoint sets because we have been given that some steel are wood. So we are not sure that chair is part of that wood or not. So we draw two diagrams for these two statements. Now let's come to the conclusion. Some wood are chairs. Now some wood are chairs. If we look at this diagram, some wood are chairs, it's true. But if we look at this diagram, some wood are chair, it's not true. So only one of the diagram can be correct. So there is an ambiguity in this diagram. Now let's judge whether the other conclusion, what does that say? Some wood are steels. So some wood and steel, that is already given to us. So some wood and steel, the common portion is there, and some steel and wood, some common portion is there. So this statement is true in both the cases, but the conclusion one is true only in one case, that is in this case. So we cannot treat it as a correct conclusion because only one of the diagram is correct, right? And this conclusion two is correct in both the cases, right? So only conclusion two follows, that is option B, right? It could be option C if this, the second statement is further an ambiguous statement, right? But as in the previous case we discussed, but the second statement is correct in both the diagrams, but the first statement is correct only in this diagram. So we cannot treat it as a correct conclusion. So option B is the correct option, right? Now let's take this question. Some bags are hot. Now let's draw the diagram. So this is bags and this is hot, and some portion is common between the two. That means some bags are hot, or we can say some hot are bags. Now all hot are cakes. That means this is the circle of hot. And it will come, the entire circle will come under the circle of cake, right? So this will be the diagram of bags, hots and cakes. Now let's come to the conclusion. The first is all cakes are bags. Now this is the portion of the, this is the circle of bag, and this is outer, this big circle is of cake. So all cakes are bags, it's not correct because the circle of cake is not coming inside the bag. So it's incorrect. Now all bags are cakes. Further, it is not correct because the circle of bags is not coming inside the circle of cake. So even this is incorrect. That means neither one nor two follows. That means option D, that is neither one nor two follows. We do not have any alternative diagram to show any of the possibility, right? So we are correct at every stage for both the statements. Nothing is reasonable. Okay, friends, syllogism problems will be very easy for you if you are able to make the diagrams, that Venn diagrams I'm talking about, right? Now let's take this. All pens are cycles. So first of all, let's draw the diagram. All pens are cycles. That means this is the circle of pens and this is the circle of cycles, right? Now next is all pigs are cycles. Now further we have two Venn diagrams. Just listen to me carefully or just see carefully. Now for this second statement, all pigs are cycle, we have two options. This is the circle of pig. The circle of pig should come inside the circle of cycle, but the situation may be like this or like this. This is also cycle, this is pen, this is pig. Now, pen and pick may be disjoint sets, and maybe pen and pick have some common portion between these two, right? So there are two possibilities. Getting me, all picks are cycles. That means the circle of pick should come inside the circle of cycle, which is there in both the cases. But what about pen and pick? They may be having some common portion between these two, between the two, and maybe these are disjoint sets. Now, let's see about the conclusions. No pig is pen. Pig and pen, right? No pig is pen. So this is true if this diagram is true, right? Because nothing is common between pen and pig. So no pig is pen and no pen is pig, right? So this may be correct if this option is correct. Now, some pigs are pens. So pig and pen, some common portion is between these two, that is. So this statement will be correct only if this diagram is correct. Now both the diagrams cannot be correct. Once again, either this diagram is correct or this diagram is correct. That means if this diagram is correct, conclusion 2 is following. If this diagram is correct, conclusion 1 is following. That means either 1 or 2 is following. Right? Both the conclusions simultaneously cannot follow either 1 or 2. That means we have option C as the correct option. Right? I hope you are getting me. We have done good number of examples. So now I am sure you must be getting some confidence on syllogisms. Let's take more problems. Now let's take this question. Now, statements, all plants are trees. Now, first of all, let's draw the diagram. So this is what? All plants are trees. So this is plant and this is trees. Now, no tree is green. That means there is no common portion between trees and green, right? So this is the diagrammatic presentation of these two statements. Now let's come to the conclusions. Some plants are green. See, all the plants are trees and no tree is green. That means between plants and green, there is no common portion as we can see in the diagram. So this is the wrong conclusion, right? Now, those plants which are not trees are green. Further, it is wrong because all the plants are trees. So this state, this conclusion is also wrong, that those plants which are not trees are green, since all the plants are trees, right? So both the conclusion are wrong. That means neither one nor two follow. That means option D, right? I hope you are clear. It's clearly seen from the Venn diagram. So we should be expert enough to draw the Venn diagrams. Let's take the next question. Now in this question, some dogs are rats. Now let's draw the diagram. So some dogs are rats. That means some common portion is there between dogs and rats, right? Now next is some rats are lions. Further, there is a scope of one more diagram. Let's draw that. Now we have two diagrams. Here some rats are lions. So lions can be like this. That means some portion of dogs it may cover or it may not. So it is, first of all, some dogs are rats. So it's dogs, it's rats, and some rats are lions. So this is the common portion between rats and lions. Now the presentation can be like this or like this. That means the circle of lion may cover dogs or may not. That means dogs or lions can be disjoint set or they have some common area in between, right? Now let's come to the conclusion. So first is some dogs are lions. So some dogs are lions. In this diagram, it is true, but in this diagram, it is not true, right? Some dogs are lions. That means we have some common area between dogs and lions. So this statement is true if this diagram is true. This conclusion is true if this diagram is true. Now let's see the other one. None of the dogs is a lion. So dog and lion, two disjoint sets are there. Now this conclusion is true if this diagram is true. So this conclusion is true for this and this conclusion is true for this. That means both the conclusion are true for individual diagrams. That means either this is true or this is true. Both the conclusions simultaneously cannot be true, right? this is true for this and this is true for this. So either one follows or two follows. That means option C, right? It's clearly a scene from the Venn diagrams. I hope you are clear. Now let's see this one. Some cups are bottles. Let's draw it. So this is some cups are bottles. So this is cups and this is bottles, and some portion is common between the two. That means some cups are bottles, or we can say some bottles are cups. Now all the bottles are glasses. That means bottles should come under another circle that is of glasses. So let's draw it. So all the bottles are glasses, right? So I just write glasses over here. Now let's see the conclusions. Now the first one is some cups are glasses. Now we can see cups and glasses, we have the common area, that is in the bigger circle and in this smaller circle, that is this circle and this circle, right? So we have this area as common. That means some cups are glasses, or we can say some glasses are cups. So it's the true conclusion. Now some glasses are bottles. See, all the bottles are glasses, and in the circle of glasses, a circle of bottle is there. That means some glasses are bottles. That is also true, right? And both the things are simultaneously true. It's not necessary that either one or two is true. Both the conclusions are simultaneously true. So we will have the option E, that means conclusion one as well as conclusion two, both of them follow, right? It's clear. Some cups are glasses. We can see the common area between glasses and cups, and some glasses are bottles. In the circle of glasses, we see an area of bottle or a circle of bottles. That means some area is of bottles, or some area of glasses is covered by bottles. That means some glasses are bottles. That is true, right? So I hope you are clear. Both the options are, both the conclusions are true simultaneously. Now friends, let's take this question. Here two statements are given and four conclusions are given. Now let's write. Some doors are mangoes. Let's draw the diagram. So some doors are mangoes. So these are doors and these are mangoes. Next is all mangoes are bananas. So let's draw another circle. Now this is the circle of mangoes and this is the circle of bananas. So it's, that means all the mangoes are bananas. That means circle of mangoes should lie inside the circle of bananas. Now this is the diagram of these two statements. Now let's come to the conclusions. All bananas are mangoes. Now we can see all bananas are mangoes. It's not true, because the circle of mango is inside the circle of banana. That means mangoes are bananas. Bananas are mango. It is incorrect. So this is incorrect. Now all the doors are bananas. Doors and bananas. We can see that the circle of doors is not coming inside the circle of bananas. So we cannot be so sure of it. So even it is not true, right? Now some doors are bananas. Doors and bananas. Now we can see some common portion between doors and bananas. This. So some doors are bananas. This is true. And some mangoes are doors. Now this is the doors and this is mangoes. Now doors and mangoes, we can see some area common. That is this area. I just changed the color of the pen. Wait a moment. This is a circle of doors. This is a circle of mangoes. So this is the common area between doors and mangoes. That means some doors are mangoes and some mangoes are doors. So this is also true. So 3 and 4, both of them are true. So only 3 and 4 follow, right? Option D is correct. I hope you are clear. Now let's see this question. Statements, no parrot is crow. That means these two are two disjoint sets are disjoint circles. So it's parrot and it is crow. Or here it also parrot and crow, right? Now all the crows are birds. Now the diagram can be drawn in two ways. I just show it. So this is the circle of birds and there it is birds. Now all crows are birds. So crows, all the crows are coming under the circle of birds, here and here both as well. All the crows, this is crows and this is birds. So all the crows are coming under the circle of birds. Now there is a possibility that some area is common between parrot and birds, and maybe any area is common between parrot and birds. So these two diagrams are the possible diagrams for these two statements, right? Now let's come to the conclusion. Some birds are parrots. So parrots and birds. It is possible that some parrots are birds if this is the diagram, but in this case it is not possible. So we cannot be so sure because we have the two possibilities. So this is not correct, right? As of now, not correct. Now all the birds are parrots. It's not at all correct because parrot and birds, either these are two disjoint circles or disjoint sets, or some of the portion is common, right? So we cannot be so sure. Now some birds are crows. Birds and crows, yes. This is a circle of birds in this case and in this case, both the cases. And some portion of this outer circle is covered by this inner circle of crows, right? That means some of the birds are crows. That is correct from this diagram and in this diagram, from both the diagrams, right? This is a circle of birds and this is a circle of crows. So some area of birds has been covered up by circle of crows. That means some birds are crows. So this is correct. Some birds are not crows. See, we cannot be so sure about the negatives, right? Because some birds are crows, we know that, but some birds are not crows, we don't know that, right? Because it is possible that the circle of crow and bat coincide, right? That means both of them are subset of each other, right? So we cannot be so sure of it. You getting my point? This is the circle of crow and this is only the circle of bats, right? Then also all the crows are bats. So this is the possibility of all the crows are bats, and this is also the possibility of all the crows are bats, right? So in this case, both the circles are coincide with each other. In this circle, it is not. That's why we cannot say that some bats are not crows, because this is also a possibility, right? And in this possibility, all the bats are crows and all the crows are bats, right? And in this possibility, only some of the bats are crows, right? So we are not sure about it. So the only statement 3 is correct, right? That is, some bats are crows. Okay, I hope you are clear. It's really very easy if you are able to draw the Venn diagrams correctly, right? And check all the possibilities. This is also a possibility and this is also a possibility. You just have to apply simple common sense. Nothing, no much reasoning skills are required over here, right? Let's do the next question. Now friends, let's see this question. And here I would suggest we just pause the session, see the problem and try on your own, then match your answer and solution with mine. That would be helpful for you to boost your confidence, right? Now let's see. All stars are planets. So let's draw the diagram first of all. So here is a diagram of all stars are planets. So this inner circle is of stars. This is planets. Now the next is all planets are trees. So we have one more outer circle over here for trees. So all the planets are trees. So this is the circle of trees, right? This is in the innermost circle is of stars, then planets, then trees, right? Now let's come to the conclusion. All planets are stars. Planets are stars. It's not correct because stars are planet. The star circle of stars, it's smaller than the circle of planets. Either they coincide or they may not. So, but we are not so sure that the circle of star will coincide with circle of planets. So we are not sure for this a conclusion, right? So all planets are stars is not correct. Only some of the planets, that is some of area of the planets is covered by the area of stars. That means only some of the planets are stars. We can be sure of that. But for entire planets, we cannot be, right? It is a possibility that stars and planets, the circle coincide, but it is not given unless until it is specified, we cannot be so sure, right? So all the planets are star, it is incorrect conclusion. Now all the stars are trees. All the stars are trees. So yeah, see the circle, this is the circle of trees, the outermost circle, and stars, circle of stars is come, the fully circle, full circle of stars is coming inside the circle of trees. That means all the stars, that is area of all the stars is covered up by area inside the trees. So all the stars are trees. That is correct, right? Now all trees are planets. It's trees and planets. Now planets are trees. The area of planet, some area of trees is covered by planets. So it is possibility that all planets are trees, but it is possible or not possible that all trees are planets, right? Just listen to me carefully once again. See, planet is the inside circle. This is planet and this is tree, right? This is tree and this is planet. Now, according to the second statement, all planets are tree. So this is the possibility or this is the possibility. That means the circle may coincide, right? All planets are trees. So the diagram for this is maybe this or maybe this. So all trees are planets. If this is the diagram, then only this is true, right? If this is the diagram, this is not true, right? So we cannot be so sure that all trees are planets, right? Now some trees are stars. Now trees is the outermost circle and star is the innermost circle. That means some of the area has been taken by stars of trees, right? That means some of the areas of trees has been taken by stars. That means some trees are stars. That is clearly true, right? Because the circle of stars lying inside the circle of trees, right? So some trees are stars. That is true. That means statement 2 and 4, both of them are following. So this is option A is correct. Okay, I hope you are clear. Friends, we did some 15-16 problems in this session and I hope now you must be getting some confidence in syllogisms. In next session, we will take some more problems based on syllogism. We'll be having 2 sessions for syllogism when I have already taken this, and one more session I'll be taking for syllogism. And before coming to the next session, do revise this session so in the next session you solve the problem on your own, right? So let's meet in the next session once again. Bye bye.